What are 5 ways to maintain healthy finances? Hey guys, I'm Ashley Lewis, and I just want to introduce myself for those of you who don't know me. So I am a part of the Life, Health, and Strength, and I have a great deal of interest and experience in finances. So I'm now in financial aid. In my company, what we do is we help students get the financial funding to attend college. But I'm so excited to bring this video to you. It is something that I'm passionate about. These views are solely my opinion and my views based on personal experience. So let's dive right on into the video. Number one. Save money. This is gonna be one of those top tips with anything dealing with finances. Save money. You wouldn't believe the amount of people who do not save on a day-to-day basis, and I don't get it. Like, if you want anything in this life, if you want to be sound in your finances, you have to learn to save money. Treat it as a bill. When you're deducting your bills from your check, go ahead and deduct that savings amount too. And then when you put it in savings, don't touch it. Use it strictly for emergency purposes only. Number two, plan ahead. I'm big on writing down things on paper. Write down your vision for your finances. Know what's coming in and what's going out. Know the due dates of your bills so you're paying on time and you know which check to pay your bill out of. Know these things, write these things down. It'll help you, I promise. If you write down a plan and stick with it, you'll notice a major difference. Number three, have multiple accounts. This is a biggie for me. Now, I'm not saying go have one at Wells Fargo, one at Bank of America, one at the credit union, try to maintain all that chaos. If you choose to do that, that's your preference, then by all means have at it. But that's just not what I choose to do. So what I mean by multiple accounts, for example, I have a credit union account. I love the credit union, not just because I used to work there, but because there are awesome benefits to banking with a credit union. With the credit union, I have one member number, and then under that one member number, I have multiple accounts. So you may have a savings one, a savings two, a vacation account, a Christmas account, and then you may have multiple checkings under that one member number. So when you log into your mobile banking or your online banking, you'll see all those accounts and you're able to navigate them at once. This is so helpful. That way you're able to separate your money. Maybe you'll have one account for all your drafts, another account for your mortgage. You may have one account for strictly savings, or you may just have one where you put your leftover money after you pay your bills. That way you know exactly what you're working with. You know exactly your budget for the next week or 2 weeks or whatever, however often you get paid. You're able to have that money separated so nothing gets missed. Number four, split bills in half, especially those large bills that are like $400 and above. Split those things up. So instead of it coming out of one paycheck, you may pay half of it one paycheck and then the other half the next. That way you're not overwhelmed with such large amounts coming out of one check and you feel like you're left with nothing. So let me give an example. Let's say you have an $800 check, right? And then so $120 come out for power bill. You may have $80 come out for water, $100 for savings. Remember, we want to deduct that out as well. And then so now let's say you have a $600 mortgage. Well, it'd be unwise to just take that $600 out that one check. That will leave you with barely anything or even put you in the red. But instead, take $300 out of one check and then $300 out of the other checks. Then by the end of the month, or whenever your mortgage is due, you have the full amount and you were not stressed out trying to pay that bill, you were not overwhelmed, and you had some money left over out of your paycheck. And number five, the final tip, is speak with a financial advisor or financial planner. There are a lot of good people out here that will love to speak with you and help you with your planning. Financial planners are able to assist with wills, health insurance, life insurance. They're able to assist with 401k retirement accounts. Take advantage of the tools around you. One thing I'm big on is life insurance. If you have life insurance at your company, that's great, But say you leave that company, well, that life insurance policy doesn't follow you. So it's always good to have an additional policy outside of your employer. So no matter where you go, no matter what you do, you still have that plan available to you permanently. It's very wise that while you're young, that you go ahead and get these types of things planned out. You want to make sure your family is taken care of, your children are taken care of, your bills, and that you're not leaving your family with the financial burden as well as grieving on top of that. So be wise about it. If you're a young, healthy adult, now is the time to go ahead and get these things lined up, because the policies are way cheaper than if you were to wait. Trust me, it's something you want to do. We want to make sure we're being very wise with our decisions and that we're being better and teaching our children as well. And my awesome brother is a financial planner. So if you guys really are interested and want to speak to someone and get this information and get these things taken care of, please see me, inbox me, comment, text me, however you can reach me, and I'll make sure to give him your contact information. We don't want to just know better, guys. We want to do better and be better. And that wraps up my 5 tips of maintaining healthy finances. I hope this video was informative and it was helpful to you. Listen, if you don't mind, go ahead and press the like button below. Also, comment below and tell us what strategies you use in your financial planning. We hope to see you next time. Bye.